Hi my angels and welcome back to my channel. This is the second time I'm trying to film this video because I had my curtains open and the light was going crazy in this room, so now I've turned them off, I've closed them, and I'm hoping that this will be a better video. Today I'm going to try and attempt to do my March favourites. I am kind of ill at the moment, so I've just slapped on loads of makeup to try and make myself look less ill, but I wanted to show you guys the things that I was loving last month, and I'm gonna get straight into this video because I feel like I've said everything like 10 times because I've been trying to film this so many times already. So the first thing that I was loving last month is this Tangle Teaser here, and it's the Aqua Splash Tangle Teaser. I basically use this in the shower because I have crazy amounts of hair and so much of it falls out when I am washing it. What I've been doing is I keep this in my shower and I comb through my hair once I put my conditioner in so that it spreads the conditioner out evenly in my hair, as well as kind of catching any hairs that are going to be falling out and clogging up my drain. I've actually been using this since I want to say about January time, but I didn't realise how much I love it until like the past like few weeks. I was like, oh my god, what would I do without this? So I've been really, really loving this. Now I feel like I can wash my hair with peace and I can grab any of the hairs before they kind of clog up any kind of drainage system. The next thing that I was loving last month is a skin serum, and that is this Origins Original Skin Renewal Serum. I'm one of those people who have kind of stopped using serum over the past, I want to say 6 months to a year. I just seem to forget, like as much as I know I should have a serum within my skincare routine, I feel like I am sometimes just too lazy to put it on. The first week that I used this, I noticed such a huge difference, which is one of the reasons why I kind of can't stop using it now. It basically really makes my skin look so much fresher and plumper and almost newer every morning that I wake up. Since using this, I've really noticed that it's minimized my pores. Over the past, I want to say 2 or 3 months, I've noticed that my pores are so much more visible, but this I feel has really, really helped because this is the only kind of thing that I've changed in my skincare. I love the smell of it, I love the texture of it. It's kind of like a gel but a cream at the same time, so it's really, really, really lovely. And I've just been really loving Origins. Every single time I'm near a concession, I just feel like I want to buy everything. So next time you do go down to Origins, definitely check it out and get yourself like a sample or something, because I've noticed a huge difference in my skin and I absolutely love it. So the last kind of skincare-y bit I've got that I was loving in March is this Best Damn Beauty lip mask, which is by Nicole Guerrero. She is also a YouTuber here on YouTube, and she is one of my favourite YouTubers and I absolutely love her, and I actually got my hands on her whole entire range a few weeks ago, but I cracked open this one first because I love lip products, and for one, not only is this a lip mask, but it's also pink in colour. You need the tiniest amount on your lips for it to do any kind of moisturising. And I like to use this a lot during the day rather than the night, purely because it has a pink tint to it. And I am wearing it on my lips right now, so it just gives your lips that kind of even pinky base. And I just love it for the days where I'm like, oh, I don't really want to wear a lipstick, and I don't just want to wear a lip balm, I want to wear something a little bit extra. It's not sticky at all. I feel like it's so light that sometimes you feel like it's not doing anything, but it's giving you so much hydration on your lips, it is unreal. And I love the packaging as well because I'm a sucker for gold and black. The next thing that I want to show you is a perfume, which is this Marni perfume here. And basically, this perfume is a dupe for the Tom Ford Spicy perfume. I'm not too sure of the name of it, but it's the spicy scented one. And I believe this one's called Marni Spice, and it smells incredible. If you've watched any of my videos, you'll know that my taste in scent has changed over the past, I want to say, 6 months or so. And I've been really liking kind of the spicier scents, and this is definitely one of them. I can't really smell it, so it's really, really nice. It's really, really musky and spicy from what I can remember when I had my smelling buds. But that is the perfume that I was loving. And then the next few things are all makeup-y bits. I want to start off with a makeup brush, and it is this Zoeva Luxe Fan Brush here. When I was like first getting into makeup, I always used to see this brush and be like, who would use this? Like, this is the most pointless brush ever. What does this even do? But since having this and kind of using it more and more, I have basically just fallen in love with this fan brush. The reason why I like this brush is because it's quite thick and dense, so you have a lot of hairs. A lot of the other ones that I've seen in the past have been very, very, very thin. But I love just applying my highlighter onto my cheeks with this. I feel like it applies such a nice glowy amount of product. I basically use it on every kind of areas of my face where I do like highlighting with my powder highlighter. But I've just been really, really loving using this. I love the Zoeva brushes in general. I think they're so fab. You get such a good quality product for the money as well. So that has been my favorite brush over the past month. The next three things are makeup-y bits. So I've been really liking my Kick-Ass Powder by Soap & Glory. And this is basically, to me, the pressed version of the Banana Powder by Ben Nye. It is a yellow tone powder, so I only use this to set any kind of areas that I have concealed and highlighted. So basically underneath my eyes, my kind of T-zone, my chin, and sometimes even underneath my contour. I feel like I use the Banana Powder more for kind of nighttime and parties and things like that, whereas this I can wear on a day-to-day basis and it's still quite light at the same time. This has definitely been something that I've used almost every day last month. Oh, I can't breathe. The next thing is a nude eyeliner, and it is this Charlotte Tilbury nude eyeliner here, and I believe it's called I Cheat for Bigger, Brighter Eyes. It is incredible. It's like smudge proof, waterproof. This basically stays for so long, and I'm just so glad that I picked this up because I have seemed to fall in love with Charlotte Tilbury, especially their packaging. But not only that, but their products are actually really, really good. So the last makeup-y bit is actually a nail polish, and it's the color that I'm wearing on my nails now, and it's this Maybelline Superstay gel nail color in the shade Uptown Blue. I feel like I included this in a favorites video last year around summertime. I friggin' love this nail polish color. Like, it just screams out spring and summer to me. When I was younger, I used to do this thing called blue tack nails, where I would actually stick blue tack on my nails, or Tippex nails, where I would actually paint my nails with Tippex because we weren't allowed to wear any nail polish at school. But this just reminds me of the good old days when I was in school, and it reminds me of blue tack nails, but I absolutely love them. I'm so glad that I finally cracked out some bright colours to wear on my nails, because it's making me feel happier, making me feel less ill as well, and it's getting me super excited for spring and summer. And then the last thing that I have been loving, not only last month, but I'm pretty sure I'll be loving forever, is my Evil Eye ring here, which is by a company called Majuri. I'll leave all their details in the info box below, but it's basically a really cute gold, my mind has just gone blank. It's a really cute gold ring with an evil eye on it, and it's just really, really cute, and I love that it's got like a chain around it, so it's not like your normal ring which has like metal all the way around it. I actually ended up getting a size too small, so it only fits on my pointy finger, and it does take a while for me to get it on and off, but I just kind of leave it there. I believe these are gold plated as well, so it's really good because it doesn't make your fingers go green or anything like that, and it's just really pretty. That is my last favorite. I'm really sorry if I didn't make any sense in this video, or if I was going off on some crazy tangent, because I really don't feel very well. But I actually wanted to also say a massive, massive, massive thank you to everyone who has subscribed to my channel, because I, over the weekend, hit 500,000 subscribers, which is beyond this world imaginable. Like, I can't even get my head around it. Like, how has this happened? I just want to say a huge, huge, huge thank you to every single person who follows me on YouTube or Instagram or Twitter or Facebook, because you are all honestly so amazing, and I have so much love for you all. I just want to give you all a big, massive e-hug, because you guys are honestly just so amazing, and all the lovely comments and everything you leave on my videos and on my Instagram, like, fill me with so much love and joy. I genuinely love each and every one of you, so thank you so, so, so much. But so that I can get this video edited, I'm gonna get going, and I shall see you all in my next video. Bye!